Hi gems and welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today's video I want to talk about dating after divorce. So I was with the same person for 16 years, married for I want to say 7 years, but then separated, and or maybe it was, I don't know, but anyway, I separated for 2 years. And in that 2 year time that I was separated is when I really started to find myself and realize the things that I liked and disliked and didn't want to deal with or would not deal with again in a relationship. And so that 2 year span, it was a lot of ups and downs. It was some of it was of us trying to work on the relationship, me having hope that maybe things could change, but also being skeptical in my mind because I know the things that I had dealt with over the years. And once you deal with things, it's like you realize this is that person's character. This is not an action. So those were the things that I was going through in my 2 year separation. But being separated allowed me to find the things that I enjoy and introduced me into the dating life. But for dating, I actually did not start to date until my divorce was finalized. So I took that time just to, you know, just enjoy my life being alone and see what it felt like. So I didn't dwell on not having a relationship anymore. I embraced the freedom that I had and the possibilities that were to come. So anyway, on to the dating part. So once I divorced, I decided, I don't know, at that point it was some aspects that came my way, and I entertained the idea. I think at this point for me, I was like, I don't want to shut people off because of what I think the guy is going to be or the guy that I'm going to end up with is going to be. I don't want to judge someone by their cover. I want to actually get to know them, their personalities, and just see how that turns out in the long run, if this could be the person. And you know, I just don't see it up front. So I dated different types of guys, and I'm not gonna say I dated a lot of guys because I really didn't. And when I say dating, I don't mean with the same guy like for a period of time. No, I mean dating as in open to the possibilities. And dating doesn't mean sex. Dating means just getting to know someone and just to see how they are. So I'm going to tell you, like, I guess my first experience of dating someone was, well, this person approached me at an event, and I thought, you know, well, you know, I'll give them a chance, you know, it seemed like a good conversation. So we exchanged numbers, and from that point it was like he would text, and I, you know, being old school, I'm not the kind of person that wants to text. I think you should, if it's someone you're trying to get to know, you want to know them by conversation, and I don't think text is the way to do that. It's not a good way to get to know somebody. So he started with the texts, and then I was like, well, are you going to talk on the phone, or is there going to be a time when we talk on the phone? And he would just like text me like sporadically, not even in a conversation type of thing. It was just like a hi, how are you doing type of thing, randomly. And then like one day he decided he was going to call, and we had really good conversation on the phone. And then after that is like he fell off again, and he would like text every now and then. And it got to a point where, and this is why you date. This is why you date first. So it got to a point where it was like, okay, what is your motive? Because you haven't asked me out. He finally asked me somewhere. We went to like a bar and really just a talk or so. And so went there, had conversation, and then at the end of the night, he wanted a kiss. And I'm like, no, like, I'm not ready for, like, I don't want a kiss. And he was, like, pretty aggressive with it. Like, I went in for a hug, and he, like, gave me a kiss close to the lips at first. And then some kind of way he actually got, he landed one. And I was like, I just looked at him like really, I did not ask for a kiss. Like, if I say that's not what I want at the time, it's not what I want. So, you know, you start to see like the type of person that you're dealing with. And then not only that, he started asking, when you coming over, you know, so when can we cuddle? And so, you know, these are the things you have to listen for. You know, so at that point I see, well, no, he's not looking for what I'm looking for. So when you're dating, you are looking for, it's basically an interview. You know, you're interviewing these guys, and you're thinking they're just supposed to put on your best effort in an interview, but that's when you really get to see the type of person that they are, is in the beginning. Because at that point, you really don't have much to lose. And there's a lot of, which I hate to say it, there are a lot of women who are willing to give anything, you know, if they, you know, just to be with someone. And these guys are like hunters for that. And so it's, you dating, you have to weed through so much. So that was my first experience. And after that, it's like the dating scene seemed similar with the rest. And I was, you know, how you're hopeful, but then you're like optimistic and like, is this what it is? Because like, this really hasn't changed since before I was in a relationship, except it's gotten worse. Like, it starts with the texting. So the guys started, the ones that I was dating, they would text more, or they would text sporadically. I had this one guy started, I met him somewhere and we exchanged numbers, and he sporadically texts me, and I would text and say hello, and he wouldn't say anything some days. And then he would speak the next day. And, you know, it's like, I'm not, like, what is this? And then one day, he out of the blue was like, I just started a job and I need $20. If you could just give me $20. And I'm like, what the heck? And this was a text message because I had never talked to him on the phone. So let's just say I have blocked so many people in that last year. That first year, I blocked a lot of numbers because of like the BS. Like, I just don't deal with the BS. So I got to a point where, I mean, I have several funny stories regarding dating, but they were pretty much all in the same direction. Another thing you need to watch out for when you're dating is narcissists, because they're everywhere. Narcissists are, it's a rough world in the dating world. So, and I don't want to go into it on this video, but if you don't know the signs, you need to definitely look up those types of videos. So when these flags are in your face, you know it's time to run. Run, girl. Don't walk. Run. So after that, the dating scene, I decided, you know, maybe I'm not supposed to be with someone at this point. I kind of just, I don't want to say I gave up, but I gave it to God. I was like, you know, I'm enjoying myself. Dating is okay. You know, at least I get to meet people. I don't have to commit to them. You know, I can always move on to the next person. I'm traveling. I have a good job. You know, I'm doing fun things and I'm enjoying my life. So I really don't need to settle down with a person. If they're, you know, if this is the way they're going to be, I'm disappointed, that's what's out here now, but I don't have to settle for this. You know, that's what happened to me before and wasted so many years. So it's like you live and you learn. So you know you don't want to do the same thing over again and be in the same predicament. So for me, after a while, I did Valentine's Day was the time when I was like, you know, I'm not talking to anybody. How about I try those dating sites? And I hadn't tried dating sites before. I hadn't tried online dating before. So I was like, I can just like log into a bunch of these, and I'm not going to use my real name, of course, because I don't know these guys. And just look in my area and see, you know, if there's any prospects. And most of the sites, I was like, I don't really want to pay for these things. I heard about Plenty of Fish, but I hadn't heard like good things out of that. I just feel like, I don't know. The things that I've heard, it sounds like it's just a thought pool. So I didn't try Plenty of Fish. I tried other sites. And one site I did have to pay, I think $20. But that was the most I paid. I think the reputable sites are like eHarmony and stuff like that, but they're like really expensive. So I kind of stuck with the cheaper ones or the free ones, and you know, just to get some conversation. You know, sometimes you just want to talk to somebody. You want to talk to a guy. And that was a way to meet more guys, but not actually have to go out, you know, if I didn't like them. Hold on. Anyway, I had to check my camera. But so with that, I ended up going on, I think one person I went on a date with from one of those sites, and they were in the area, and I remember seeing them at an event. So I was like, okay, well, I was checking them out at the event. You look pretty cool, you know. We'll go out. Let's just say we went to this restaurant, and it's a local restaurant that is well known, and I had never been before. It's not an expensive restaurant, but we were having conversation, and actually he was having more of the conversation. He liked to talk, and so I listened, and the food was taking forever to come out. The restaurant wasn't good. The food came out late. It was cold. And so I was like, we had been there for a while. So I was hungry. This was my first meal. And I was like, okay, so you want to go somewhere else? Because he told the waitress, like, don't worry about it. We don't want it or whatever. Send it back. And so I'm like, okay, so are we going somewhere else? And you know, this Negro did not want to go nowhere else. He was like, and I realized, okay, he's a cheapskate. So instead of him wanting to take me, you know, or go, we can go out somewhere else to eat, he basically got off with a free date at a cheap restaurant, and he just wanted to sit and talk, basically talk and hear himself talk. And that was it. We just ended the date. And after the date, I kind of, you know, I didn't want to be rude, so I was like, I appreciated the conversation or whatever, and I didn't hear anything. It was like crickets, like no text back. And then like out of the blue, like maybe like a month later, he like texts hello. I'm like, what is this? Cause somebody leave me a comment below and let me know your experiences with dating, because I don't remember experiencing this level of like laziness back in the day. So it's like I don't understand. I don't know. I guess I have no clue. But anyway, that was one of my online dating stories. And so that went left. But you know, there was good that came out of it, because that is how I met my husband. And it's funny because like we met on Valentine's Day over phone conversations, And we married on Halloween the same year. So, but yeah, through him, meeting him, it was more like, I think at that time we were just looking for the same thing at the same time. Well, not me personally. I don't think I wasn't looking, but I was open to the possibility. But him, I think he was looking, and me, I was like, oh, okay. Well, at first I was like, we'll see. He's very handsome, I think. And so I don't know. Like, you know, they have a lot of, you know, the type of guys that are online. So I kind of wanted to wait it out, have conversations, see where the conversations went. And I was pleasantly surprised. And, you know, it threw me back, because I was like, wow, like, really? I'm shocked. But I am glad that I didn't close off this possibility. You know, it wasn't what I was looking for. I didn't think I was going to find anyone. I just went on it for conversation and company for Valentine's Day, and it turned into a marriage. So, yeah. But you can find, the thing about dating is, you hear my neighbors. Wow, I hear you. The thing about dating, I say all that to say, is dating is a good thing, but you have to know what you're looking for. One thing I didn't realize that I did, and I went back and I found some notes that I wrote later on, is that I wrote down things that I wanted in a relationship, in a person, the way I wanted this person to be. Now, I'm not talking about like very detailed things, but I mean things like a caring person, a good heart, a hard worker, someone who loves kids, and someone who, you know, is supportive of me. These are things that I wanted in a relationship. And so when you start to talk and have conversations, as a matter of fact, if you have more conversations over the phone before meeting someone, it's also good, because you get to see where this person's mind is, you know, even before you go out on a first date. So that's why I think that's so important. And not just ask questions like, you know, questions on the surface, like, how was your day? But you have to really dig deep into a person's mind to find out what they're thinking. How do they see themselves in the future? Are they looking to marry, if that's what you want? How do you view your family? What are your family values? How do you feel about church? Are you a Christian? Things that are going to fit into your life. And when you see that this is not going in the right direction, the person that you're talking to is not suitable, don't waste time with that person thinking that you're going to either sway them, or they're good looking, I can get around that, because you're going to be stuck with that in the long run. And that's the mistakes that I made. So those are some things I think that, you know, are very helpful. I think you should really like look into what you want before you start dating, and don't settle for less. Don't settle for something or someone based out of peer pressure, or I'm getting too old, or you know, all of my friends are together and married. Do it for yourself, because I find a lot of my happy moments were by myself. A lot of them. That freedom to do what I want to do and not be bound is a great feeling, which is why, you know, I started solo traveling and things like that. And I do have a video on here on how I got started solo traveling, so if you haven't watched it, take a look at it. And But those things are things that are so valuable that you will learn in life if you just take time to know yourself first. So, yeah, I don't want to make this video super long. It's probably long right now, but I can talk for days, which is why I enjoy doing these type of videos instead of so much as hair videos, because I don't have to edit these videos like I had to do with hair videos. And I think this is good because it, I think it could be helpful to someone. So, yeah, I want to do some more Spanish videos. I think you guys really like those. And I'm trying to think of some subjects that would be good to talk about on those as well. So if you have any tips for that, leave comments below. And also, if you have been dating or divorced and living this date life or living the date life, let us know in the comments below what you experienced, or you know, how you met the one that you're with, if you're with the right one. That's another good thing. So, all right, and I will talk to you guys on the next video. All right, bye.